audience, if you come up to the podium, please, please, please state your name and address for the record and speak loudly so that you can be heard. Thank you, Vice Mayor.
So I go back to, I'll make a motion that we accept the second reading and final ordinance 2017-03.
Vice Mayor, if I may have a roll call vote, please. Vice Mayor French?
Yes.
Commissioner Felder? Felder?
Yes.
Commissioner Lewis Felder?
No.
Commissioner Bradley?
Yes.
Let the record reflect 3-1-A. Commissioner Lewis Felder, Mayor Ward absent.
Now we'll open the public comments section, but we want to welcome everybody here tonight. We want everyone who has comments to be recognized, and we therefore ask that you fill out a speaker card and submit it to the clerk. But please be advised that it's not responsible to expect that board members will engage in debate or deliberation about matters on which the board has not received prior information as part of the agenda packet. If you feel that you have an issue that require more than 3 minutes, allotted in the public comments, and will need the board's action, please submit your agenda request in writing and all supporting correspondence to the clerk on the first Tuesday prior to the regular meeting, no later than 2 p.m. And we ask that you refrain from speaking in the audience so that we can record this. Do we have any general public comment cards?
No, sir. I have no.
Sorry. If you would, please mute your cell phones unless you're an EMT paramedic or a doctor. If there is no public comments,
apologize for my smokiness. Thomas Cave III, 115 Chase Street, Hayden, Florida. Pretty much after what Johnny said tonight, and I don't always agree with Johnny, but I think he kind of slammed the door on what I wanted to say, because I simply wanted to, again, reaffirm my love for the community and also for even this, the respect of our town council and their efforts. A few things that I've said in the past is that I don't blame this present council for anything that happens in Hayson or have gone on in Hayson for the last several years. Our lack of goals is a history, and you're not responsible for that, but you could be responsible for the changes that could possibly take place if the town was to progress towards dissolution. As a Christian, I'm always looking for things I can be thankful for, and as I said this the first time I spoke, I'm thankful that I live in the city limits of Hastings. I'm thankful that the church that I pastor in the city limits of Hastings, both I've had achievements personally, and I've had achievements at the church personally. New roof going on the building right now, and had to come through my township to get these things done. So it's been a good journey for me, but I think beyond me, if I'm going to think progressive as a almost 60-year-old man, yet young in spirit, want to think progressively, and I would feel that any business-minded person would see this as an opportunity, but I can only speak for myself, to progress our community into something that could be better. I understand the history between the county and the city. I've experienced that firsthand. Again, having to deal with the county through the city was easier for me rather than have to go straight to the county. There were seasons when dealing with the county was better. So I've been on both sides of the issues. I'm not a realtor, I'm not a contractor. I don't have to go downtown for certain things. What I've been able to do, I've been able to get through our township. That's been a blessing. It's truly been a blessing. But I do see beyond that. I see beyond that. And I may not even be here to see it, but I would love for those coming up behind me to have a greater opportunity, a better opportunity for not just for growth, but for businesses. For businesses or things of that nature. And I don't know if that can be achieved on our present path, because we've had years and years of opportunity to do that, and granting don't get it done. And so and so the question in my mind is, okay, is there a great fight that I would be facing if our town was dissolved and having to face the county alone? Yeah, but without, you know, trying to belittle where I live at, I think I got something then to fight for. And I just don't see much to fight for other than my township's name right now, and with little opportunity. And so I think the broader picture says to my mind that as a progressive individual, as a pastor, is that I have a better opportunity to go to that county over there and fight for some things, despite what it looked like in the past. There's something to fight for. You know, a house here, a building there, every now and then in our little community, for me, is not progress. And I close by saying this, and I'm gonna quote Johnny, it ought to be on the ballot. Thank you.
We will close public comment. All right, consent agenda.